sacked because my co-workers are all getting royalties, and they told me to stop talking about intergenerational birth defects. I've done a case study, I've presented it to the UN. I'm now serving genocide notification to you as Premier. I wish it hadn't come to this point. I've got three ovaries. I deal with brain cancers in my nephew. I deal with everything. Uranium mining, uranium activity is not a solution. I'm not normally like this. I'm really upset that it had to come to this point, but people are not listening. My family are dying. Here's the genocide case that I've been working on, and I'd like to hand it to Mike. I've lodged it with the UN. I'm really, really sorry that it came to this, but my mum, Eileen Wingfield, she's the 2003 Golden Environment Prize winner. She asked me to talk to Mike about this. I don't usually get out of this control, but my family are dying and it's very close. So Mike, I'm handing you the genocide case study. And it is not the UN.
History here, because then the British government in the 1950s, during the time of the Menzies Liberal government, exploded nuclear bombs in South Australia. It exploded nuclear bombs that has caused devastation for the Maralinga Jarrada people and also caused devastation for many others. It was an absolute pouring of poison.
And no compensation.
And exactly right, no compensation. And you know what? Some of us, when I was Minister for Aboriginal Affairs, who, by the way, introduced and passed legislation both then and as Premier to give land rights to the Maralinga Jarrada people, I went with Maralinga elders to London to ask for compensation and clean-up. And you know what? I find it bizarre that someone would be here today attacking those who actually supported her own group. Thank you very much.